What if I were to say to you, what up? It's the trooper. What if I said that? What would you think about that? As hard as I tried to get to the strip before dark, shit was working against me today, y'all. Especially the fact that the clocks went back last night. Yesterday. You know what I mean? Sunday night, the damn clocks went back. I'm okay with that. I don't care that much about it, but getting to the strip before dark was a challenge. I actually thought I had made it when I parked. It was still kind of daylight. It got really dark really fast, but it's super cloudy. Super cloudy. Looks like it's gonna pour rain. I actually like that idea. But what if it's raining when I come out the casino? I parked all the way at the Mirage, and I'm gonna play poker at the Venetian. I'm gonna get wet. Tomorrow's election day, y'all. You gonna go vote? I should have voted early. I don't really know how that works. I don't know if there are any requirements to do so. Old Man Coffee told me that there are no requirements. All you do is show up and vote. That the polls are open, you just go over there and vote. I should have done it already, but I didn't. But I will be voting tomorrow, 100%. The only thing that will stop me is death. And by the time you see this video, it's gonna be too damn late to kill me. So I'm gonna be voting tomorrow. I mean, I'm not looking forward to the process of voting, but it's my damn duty. It's my damn duty as a responsible American citizen. Plus, I'll be really happy when this election is done, because I am sick and tired, so sick and tired of these friggin' text messages from politicians and campaigns nonstop. I get like 7 or 8 a day, and it's just annoying. I'm a little embarrassed to say that I didn't always vote. There were quite a few elections that went by during my lifetime so far that I didn't participate in. And it's embarrassing. I'm embarrassed to say that there was ever a time once I turned 18 that I didn't vote. Because regardless of what a lot of people try to say these days, this country and the system of government that we have here is for sure the greatest that has ever existed on the planet. And that's my opinion. And I believe that opinion is shared by quite a few. And many millions of people have fought and died for my right to go to the polls tomorrow and vote. And I feel like that's a responsibility. And I'll tell you what I think is aside from the idea that a lot of people don't think their vote matters or are too lazy or whatever to go vote. I want to say that I think, other than that, I think one of the biggest problems in the United States of America today is that people vote on very, very, very selfish issues. So in other words, it's kind of like a kid. It's like all kids are selfish. I can think back to times when I was a little kid and I wanted something, and the consideration of what my mom or grandmother or whoever, what they had to go through to give me what I wanted, you know, it wasn't that big of a, it wasn't really present, that consideration. Considering what the cost is to someone else, just so I can have something that I want, but I really don't even need, and it's extremely selfish. Now, I was a kid, so I can't beat myself up about that too much. I have one huge regret. When I was 18 years old, I wanted wheels, you know, rims for my truck. And my grandmother wanted to get them for me. And if I recall, I think they were only $900 for the set. But I still to this day absolutely regret mentioning it, daring to ask for it. I don't know if I asked, I probably did. And I certainly regret allowing my grandmother, who worked her entire life, to buy those wheels for me. And I know it probably gave her a little bit of joy, but I think the joy that she got from giving it to me was certainly secondary to the joy that she got from providing me food, shelter, transportation, clothing, or anything else I might have actually needed as a kid, so that I could survive and grow up to be an adult human being living in America today. And so it was just a super selfish thing. And I know, there are people who vote from pure selfishness and they don't really consider what the cost is gonna be to their kids, if they ever have kids, or what their cost is going to be to their neighbors or the country as a whole, or the survival of this sovereign nation that we all, every single one of us, take advantage of. Every person in this country, even if you're homeless, even if you're rich, no matter who you are, everyone takes advantage of what we have here because we were all born into this. And the only people who might not take unfair advantage would be people who were born elsewhere, came to this country, knows what it's like to live somewhere where you're not free. You're not free to say what you want to say. You're not free to love who you want to love, be with who you want to be with, do the job you want to do, have the food and the house that you want. You can do all of that here. I don't give a shit who you are. I mean, I was raised with practically nothing, and I still sort of have nothing, but I have the right to go try to achieve whatever I want to achieve. And so I would urge you to really look at, you know, what your voting decisions, how they're going to affect the country as a whole, freedom as a whole, and not just your own selfish desires. I watched a YouTube video today where they interviewed a homeless guy in San Francisco, and they said, "Why are you homeless?" And he said, "Because they pay me to be homeless. They give me $620 a month, plus $200 a month in food stamps." And they're like, "What do you have to do? What process is there for you to get that?" And he said, "Nothing but a phone call. All I had to do was make a phone call and they give me this money. So why would I do anything else?" That's a very selfish person. That $820 comes from people who work their balls off, like your parents, like the people who have lived in this country for generations. So listen, whatever. I'm just telling you, I'm going to vote. And I'm going to vote who I believe will be the best for the country, not just myself. Damn, got some soapbox action going. Let's go play poker. We'll be right back. volcano is still going, but not for long. I think they know the day that it won't be going any longer, but I don't know what that day is. I only played a couple hours tonight. I don't think I realized how tired I was. You know, I was working on the podcast until 3:30 in the morning, and I had a whole bunch of stuff to do today. So I called it an early night. Tomorrow's election day. I want to make sure I get up and vote. And I end up winning 126. But unlike last night, the game wasn't that good. Not my game. I could have moved if I was going to stay longer, but calling it a night early. Speaking of podcast, I think that a lot of you might like the podcast that went up yesterday. Because I tell the origin story. The origin story of the Trooper, how I got into poker, how I became the Trooper.
And the guy, his name was John, he was like, you're really good at dealing cards. He was like, you should come deal my cash game on Tuesdays. Random offer, out of the blue. I say, I'm in.
Well, I guess I've always been the Trooper. But how I got into poker, which led to me moving to Vegas and all of that good stuff.
Personnel can get you one right away. You don't even need to leave your...
And with that, my friends, this Monday draws to a close. I know what you're thinking, Trooper. You got some green screen action going? You at home? And this is all like green screen? No, that's real. It's real, yo. That's the view you get from the Mirage Garage. That shit rhymed. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I think it's gonna rain tomorrow, y'all. I think it's gonna rain big time. I'll see you next time.